Hey guys, down here in the engine compartment of a Prestige 520S, who is one of our weekly wash preventative maintenance customers. We are doing weekly washes, exterior, windows, stainless, the whole kit and caboodle. Plus we do every week, I go down in the engine compartment, check the oil levels, check the fluid levels, making sure the seacocks work, the strainers are clean, all that. So doing it in order to prevent or at least identify items that could cause issues later and work to stop that. So with that said, one of our things that I've noticed in this vessel is in the C-strainer of the generator, looks a little clogged up. I'll show you what we're looking at and kind of walk you through why this is an important program. All right, so down in here, and when it's all together, it's hard to see, it's cloudy, but I kind of could see there was some items in this C-strainer. So what I did is went through, unscrewed it all, got a little handy toolkit just to carry with me. So we'll pop this off, and I'll pop that out, set that to the side. I'm gonna open this up, I'm gonna clean this so then I can see better, because that makes it easier. That's the reason it's plexiglass or glass, so you can actually see through it. So anyways, we'll fix that. But looking down in there, you see a lot of crud, which could cause an issue. This is where the water comes in from the bottom of the boat into the sea strainer, which obviously collects. This is, it's doing its job. It's collecting any junk that gets caught from the water and then goes and goes up into the bottom of the generator, which will then supply it with the water that it needs to cool its system. So anyways, we're going to remove this once I can get it out of here and clean this out, show you what it looks like. So this is kind of a unique situation. This sea strainer is a little basket like in a pool filter or something that should pop right out with this little handle. But it looks like this fitting is screwed in a tiny bit too far, thus blocking me from removing it. However, I'm able to kind of dig my hand in there. Not a clean gig. Captaining isn't always sunshine and sunsets and rainbows, but putting all the crap over here to kind of look at all of this type of stuff is what can be getting through this filter potentially at some point. Little hard, this is hard pieces of plastic that gets sucked up in the water, maybe going through the locks, and this can get into the actual generator, your engine of your vessel, and cause big issues. So we're gonna clean it out as much as we can in this current setup and go from there. So value of preventatively checking all this stuff is a huge issue. So this is the cap that I wanted to clean off. Just one of my dirty old rags in here. So now that's a lot more see-through than it was before. I'm gonna go ahead and reapply it here. Let's back that off for a minute because I just remembered this O-ring needs to go in there. So that would have been a not the best idea. So that O-ring will sit right in this channel and make sure the channel's clean. Wipe off the bottom of this glass because it's still see some fingerprints. There we go.
A little socket wrench.
Now back over here, this is the water intake from the bottom of the boat. So we can return open the sea strainer, the water seacock that is, and the water will then be ready to flow into the unit and then into the generator eventually. So we'll clean this up and we'll move on to the next check. All right, so I moved to the back of the engine compartment here, engine room. All the way in the corner, kind of looking through the engines. We did the oil checks. The oils look fine. They were all changed over the winter anyways. So clean oil, full oil. So that looks good. But
I did notice a couple spots that there might be some drips, and whether this was a previous old drip that has been just sitting there, whether it's a drip that is new and is coming somewhere off the engine, this is part of what we're doing, part of what we're looking at. Just keep an eye on it. So take notes of it. I can clean it up now. And then as we go along next week when I come back, if there's more drips, then we start looking at where it might be coming from. So I'll show you what it looks like, and we'll keep going.
So here's a spot, kind of an oily, a little bit of grease. Might just be something that was greased to clean up or something else. So I'm felt around this whole part, looking around by the engine. You know, no obvious oil leaks anywhere. Typically, if you're seeing something dripping down there, you're looking right above it. Where might it be dripping from? And I don't see anything. So that might lead me to believe that maybe it came from maybe a jug that was in here of some trans fluid or some other types of oils. So looks okay. Everything else looks all right. But again, this is something we keep our eye on. I'll clean it up. Then we know if I come back and we see some of the same coloring or same drips, then we pay attention and dig further.